stuff. I went to Sac Anime.
Oh, you know what?
I'm not gonna show off all my spoils from Sac Anime, but I did get this, which is a little King Dedede pixel art keychain, like with perler beads. And he's cute. What? Why'd you say what? I see. I understand. Show the merch. Show the spoils. No. No, that's okay. You know. Oh, I do have another Kirby thing, but this wasn't from Sac Anime. I do have this hoodie. Raise it up a little bit. It's like a Kirby. It's like an ombre Kirby. Oh, I don't know how to frame things in the camera because it's like backwards. Forget the artist who does this. It's like Luma or something. Other people. Omona. So then I got this bag, which was actually free. It was crazy. It was this whole deal. They had like a bigger, like, how you say it? Right now I have like a little crossbody bag. They had like a big fish version of a crossbody bag, and I saw it. It was $40, and I was like, nah, I don't know. But then later I was like, okay, let me go get it. And then it was sold out. Within like 2 hours, it was sold out. So then I didn't get anything that day, and then the next day I went, I was like, okay, what do you guys have? And they had like small reusable bags that like fold into little fish cases, and then also like a ramen one. It's like the spicy, I think it's like the Buldak noodles. Show this real quick. Show the back. And then they were buy two, they're like $20 each, but then they were buy two, get one free. And then if you spent $40, you get that green frog bag free. So that's what I did. So I spent $40 and got four bags. So they evened out to $10 a bag. So I was very happy about that. Sad I didn't get the crossbody bag. I think they still have it on their website. They had clothing too. The only thing I really want clothing-wise from them, I saw the reversible frog jacket, which I was like, well, maybe I'll get that, but I don't think it's really my style. And then there's like a hot pot sweater that I want to get, but they didn't have that one. You got so much good stuff. I did. Is somebody nerd got so much stuff, me and unnamed friend we both have, to protect privacy, we're kept making fun of the fact that like it was insane. Like you just have like a full bag of stuff. It is crazy. I will show these little like I don't they're like embroidered tags. So I have a Lugia and a Jirachi, and I think these were cool. They also had like pin versions, but I actually really liked the embroidered tag version of these more. But yeah. Hopefully you could you actually see that as well. I had to like hold it close to the camera. Oh, that's better. Not amazing, because then you lose the light, but oh, I got this like Spinda plush, which is crazy because Spinda's not like I don't dislike Spinda whatsoever. But he's I've never really thought of Spinda as like my favorite Pokemon or anything, but like I just saw the fucking plush and I was like, oh, I have to have him. Like for whatever reason, Spinda mania was like consuming me. And then today I'm shipping out a bunch of I want to go next year. So yeah, so Sac Anime, for those of you who don't know, has two events every year. So there's the summer show, which is what I just went to. There's also the winter show, which is basically like around December. One time it was like around New Year's. Sometimes it's like a little earlier. Sometimes it is just in January. Sometimes it's like January like 2 through 4. But yeah, so you can either wait till just my nerd, you can either wait till August of next year, or if you don't want it to be hot, because it was kind of hot. I don't think it was that hot on Sunday, but Saturday. But like it's air conditioned and like the artist alley. But yeah, so like we could go in winter, because me and unnamed friend were already talking about how we might do a group cosplay for the winter show. So definitely tell let us know. But it's funny because all I did, like I bought the tickets and everything. All I did was Artist Alley. Like I didn't go to panels or anything. Because we were too late. The only one we were maybe gonna go to was like K-pop battles, because K-pop battles and J-pop battles are pretty fun. And I do think I want to go to K-pop battles next time. Yes, different yeah, it's different vendors and different artists for like every single show. They don't really I mean I think they tell you like within like a month of like before it starts. They're like, okay, these are like the vendors that have signed up, but yeah. or like artists, because those are technically two separate things, the vendors and the artists. Yeah, it was really fun. Yeah, I like to go just for Artist Alley, just to see all the different stuff that there is, because I feel like there's, I don't think there's ever been a second maybe where I haven't wanted to like get something cool. And then now I have like a job, so I was actually able to get pretty much everything I wanted except for that crossbody bag that sold out. The only artist that wasn't there, there was an artist I think pre-COVID actually, that did like pixel art like shadow boxes. Like they actually have the scene. Like I know they had one of like Link taking the Master Sword out from like Link to the Past and Little Garden area. Even though I don't like Link to the Past, but they had like other scenes like that was really cool. Other than that, I don't even think there was anything like super expensive that I was like, oh man, I wish I could afford this. Not because I could, but just because I just didn't see as much. There weren't that many posters and prints as I usually get, which is good because I already have enough that need to be framed and hung up. But yeah, it was definitely more so stickers, plushes, clothing. I am glad that I can afford the clothing because I did get a sweater. Oh, I should show the sweater I got. And disembodied nerd, this might look familiar because it was the sweater. I was like, oh, do you want this? Anyway, it's just this like cat cactus. I don't know if you can really see it that well on camera, but it's like a cat cactus sweater that's like, she like, let me put it on. She's like, yeah, there's one 2XL left. She's really nice. I guess she's like new into doing all the sack anime and like vendor stuff. And she's like, yeah, you can try it on. It's last 2XL. And then I put it on. I was like, this is insanely comfortable. And so then I bought it. So I'm very happy about that. Disembodied nerd, this entire bag is all stuff for you. It is crazy. Except there's one thing that's for someone else. Which I believe is should be in this bag. Yes, it is. Yeah. Yes. But definitely a lot of surprises in there. It's gonna be very fun. No problem. Yeah, no problem. They just had, it was the one thing me and unnamed friend were talking about, I think they've been in the Twitch channel, Mellow Recon on the Twitch channel. We kept talking about like this sack anime was basically designed for you, like the theme was stuff that disembodied nerd would like. It was insane. It was so, I actually had to stop myself. There were like one or two things where I'm like, no. I was like, no. Because I had to go, I went 2 days. I went on Saturday and Sunday. On Saturday, I did not get a single thing for myself except for that King Dedede keychain. Oh, well, it's hung up there, but right now it's here. That was the only thing I got myself. And then everything else was either stuff for disembodied nerd, or just stuff for people in general, but the majority was disembodied nerd stuff. And then Sunday was more stuff for me, and then there were, like, one or two other things for, like, other people, like Sexar, who's been in the Twitch chat. I regret not going. Yeah, no, absolutely. You should 100% go with me and Mellow Recon next time. I think it's, like, $35 for the weekend pass if you, like, pre-order early. So I would definitely recommend, I would just get the weekend pass. Saturday is when like the big stuff happens. Saturday is also when like basically the good and bad of it is that Saturday is when everyone's there. Friday, obviously there's like less people usually, but like people work Friday. So like obviously you may or may not be able to like go, but like Saturday is when like everyone's there, and it's also when like usually all the merch is there. So Sunday I went, and like it was good because there were less people and it's more walkable, but also there's like less merch that's like available for sale because like stuff has sold out usually by Sunday, which so like pros and cons. But yeah, I went Saturday and Sunday. Did I get tickets yet? No, I have not gotten tickets yet. They had a, because normally it was a thing where like you could pay like $25 for like the weekend pass, pretending like I'm wearing my bracelet, if you did it at the event. But now it's like $35 at the event to pre-order for the next one. It was $35 when I did it online anyway. They'll tell you. They like, I'm on like the email list. They'll tell you it's like $35. Yeah. So the next event is January 5th through 7th. And let me see, can I register right now? It just says updates, so it doesn't look like yeah, I don't think you can register for the January show just yet, but like give it like, I don't know, a month or two. They're usually around the same price of like the 35 to 40 and all that. Let me know when you do it just so I can remember to do it. Yeah, I'll let everyone know. I'll just put it in the Discord again. But yeah, okay. Cool. So now, Disembodied Nerd, since you're here, you get to decide what game I play, because I wasn't sure what to play. So there's either We Love Katamari or there's Dead by Daylight. And I was thinking about We Love Katamari because I do have to beat this on stream, but also I've been playing a lot of Dead by Daylight recently. And like, not to like brag, but like I'm getting pretty good at it. I don't know. So yeah, you get to be the deciding factor for which game I play. So I'll let you think on that. And then I'm trying to think if there was anything else either to show from Sac Anime or talk about at Sac Anime. Wear a face mask. I wore a face mask to Sac Anime just because it's like not even COVID, but like even before COVID, like it's just like a thing with like conventions where like you'll get sick. So like I don't have COVID. I took a negative COVID test, came back negative, but definitely like yesterday I remember just like feeling a little sick. And then now I feel like a lot better. And then I also did like I went to a concert last week, so like obviously that could also have played a part in it. And like I was like, oh man. But I already knew from the concert where I was like, oh, my throat feels a little funny. Not because I was sick, it's because I was screaming a lot and I lost my voice. And I know that that's what it was because the exact same thing happened to me after the Fall Out Boy concert. And what's weird is you would think that I would scream more at a Fall Out Boy concert than a Beyonce concert. And like But that's, or at least louder, maybe. I'm not really sure what happened, but Beyonce, like, I lost my voice that night. It came back the next day, but like after the concert, I had lost my voice. How long are you playing for? I want to see both. Yeah, okay, cramped in there. Y'all look so good. Thank you. I'm only playing till one because I forgot to do the disclosure. This is my lunch break for work, so this is my 1 hour lunch break. So I could try to do both, but it's easier to pick one because otherwise you're not going to see a lot of either. Yeah, it did get cramped. That was the one thing Mellorican did not like, was that some people are just not good in crowds, and get a little too pushy, especially when it comes to like separating me and Mellorican. Like for whatever reason, other people can travel together in duos fine, but people like need to separate us for some reason. It's very weird. But yeah, that is the one thing. But that was a Saturday thing. Sunday again, I just went by, like I went solo, but like it was extremely more walkable, and I was there for like 2.5 hours Saturday and then 2 hours Sunday, just like going down every single, it's like huge now, it's crazy, and I just walked down every single aisle. And like there was stuff we missed Saturday just because it was hard to like almost like remember like which row and then to, all that. But it was crazy. It's fun. It's fun. It's really nice. And it's not like that bad. If it was that bad, I wouldn't go. In terms of like cramps and like people like being annoying about it. It's really not that bad, in my opinion. Okay. But Disembodied Nerd, pick one. Try to just pick one. I know that is bisexual in the tags. No, thank God. But this is a stream where we pick one thing and one thing alone. I don't think I posted any fit pics from the Beyonce concert, actually, which is crazy. I should have. Katamari, you got it. I don't even think that was on my story. I think my story was like just the concert. I don't think I remembered actually post any fit pics, which is, but like I have one or two that people took. I never took any of my own, I don't think. Oh no, I think I took a couple of my own. I don't know. I think I put one, but it was mostly like a selfie. You can't actually see like the hat or like the patches on the jacket or like the UFO light up and stuff like that. It's really good. And then I had like these chains with like reflective tape on the jeans, and like I was very proud of it. It looks pretty good. There's some parts that like need a little bit of work. Like I definitely like it was definitely a learning experience because I'm not used to doing that kind of stuff. But like I definitely know that like next time like I know how to do it. It looks kind of cloudy. Okay. Hi, Your Highness. Everyone in my school loves Katamari Damacy. Students, teachers, we all play together. Anyway, Your Highness, it's our field trip tomorrow, but it's supposed to rain. So we talked about dirt. Oh, wait, hold on. Let me make sure the game audio is playing. It is, yeah. We kind of decided to ask you to roll up the rain clouds. Can you help us out? Yes. Ever since those like two or three Katamari streams where there was like no game audio and no one told me. So everyone hates me and everyone's against me. I do not remember the voice I was giving this dude. Hello, the prince. So floaty and flitty. You make it look easy, but flying is actually hard work, isn't it? What? What? Roll up clouds? We thought this was about flying. When did we finish talking? Like, you can even roll up clouds. I want to be like the king when I grow up. I do that voice every fucking time. Like us. Don't give up. Clouds can be rolled up, no doubt. Come to think of it, we did in Katamari Damacy. Yes, let's go roll up some clouds. Is Katamari Damacy written? What was he going to say? Ah, so light and fluffy. The sky is a nice place to be, but there's a lot of rain. Then again, that can be refreshing, too. Okay, then roll up the floaty, fluffy clouds, and in about this much time, clear up the whole sky and make it sunny. We knew you can do it, the prince. Good luck. The voice was really getting away from me on that one. What? Okay. Oh my god, this is weird. Oh, the camera angle, everything is, like, weird, because I'm, like, on top of things. Okay. I'm just gonna roll, I guess. God, okay. This is very weird. Oh, there's like little ice cream clouds. That's fun. Okay, here's like a bunch of clouds I should be able to roll up right here. Nope, I can't roll them up. Damn it. I'm trying to think of anything else to talk about. I don't think so. He's texting me. Why am I getting texts? Every time. Oh, okay, cool. Well, I know what I'm doing after stream. Hey guys. Oh, there's a cousin over there playing jump rope. Got him. Cousin June. I could, like, find some other clouds that I can actually roll up. That'd be so cool. Be so awesome. But it was crazy. The fucking Beyonce birthday show concert was yesterday night, and like basically all my thirst follows were there, and I was like, wow, I would have really had a show. I would have really had a show. It was great, and like all in different angles. But then it also makes you reevaluate, like, oh well, this thirst follow is like all the way back there, so like I'm not that thirsty anymore. I don't know. Also, like one person I know in real life, who is a sicko, a real sicko, and was fucking front seat, and he's taking everything from me, and that's just the truth. I don't know. We did get really good seats though for concert, which I was very, very lucky. But my god, do I want to go again? And then Diana Ross was there, and then Kendrick Lamar was there, even though his microphone was off for like I think the majority of his verse, which sucks. But yeah. And now we're actually at like a normal angle, but we're also like halfway done in terms of timing, so. I think for the purposes of the stream, I might not keep going back to stages and perfecting them, but I'm not sure. I don't know. Part of me wants to, part of me doesn't want to, because I feel like there's a lot more stages in this one compared to Katamari Damacy, and I don't want this to be, not that I don't like Katamari, but I don't want this to be like, he only played Katamari, you know, on and off for like several months, and it never ended. Okay, seems like we're getting good progress here, though. Okay, well, this one we might be able to do good, because it seems like this one's like kind of like a gimme. I still have 2 minutes. I mean, I'm about to have 1 minute. Yep, okay. I'm trying to think of what the game would tell me is like a good amount. I want to say it's 300, but I'm not entirely sure. No, 300 was way too easy. Maybe like 350. It might be 400, to be honest, but it's just like, no, it's probably 300. Probably 400 is 3. Even that was pretty easy. Oh, yeah. Even 400, I think, might be, like, almost all of them. It's, like, 350 is, like, quite a bit. But either way, just keep on rolling. Even though, I forget, is it about the amount of... I'm trying to flip. Amount of clouds, or is it the size? And it's just, like, just so happened to be telling me about the amount of clouds. 400. Nope, I'm not gonna get... Oh, yeah, no. It's probably... Yep! 390. Okay, well, let's see what he says. It's good to roll the sky sometimes. All right, you want to go home? Yeah, let's say yes. I don't know. I think now it's like the problem was like just the start. And then once you like get going, it really gets going. I was definitely starting way too slow. But maybe he'll just like it. Maybe it's fine anyway. Oh, the sky is nice. Space is nice, but the sky is delightful too. The contrast between clouds and the sky is beautiful. As beautiful as this Katamari. Oh, where did this come from? What a half-baked Katamari. We don't know whether it's clear rating. Lighty, cloudy, so wishy-washy. 390 clouds, wishy-washy. Okay. Should have known. Okay. Yeah. I shouldn't have expected anything from my Katamari. Beat that kid's ass. I'm gonna beat that kid's ass. I don't know who the fuck he thinks he is. Ooh, what time is it? 12:30? Not even 12:30. Okay, we're good. I was like, what do I have to do? I have to do stuff. Oh! Cutscene. The lion never falls or fails. Oh, is this the dad dying and passing on the title? He's the king. I don't love this game. Oh no, he's alive. Oh, okay. He's still king. Well, there's that. Good for him. We also love Raincoat Girl. I do not fuck with Raincoat Girl. Let's try this shit again. I actually don't think there's that many sages left, to be fair. I think I actually, before I like took my pause that was never intentional. Well, I mean, I got a job, I guess, was the pause. Okay, let's go. I can do this. Just keep on getting the small clouds when I can. Get nice and big and strong. I'm gonna try to hold back the urge to talk like a babe. Okay. These maybe. Okay. Oh, yes, yes, yes. Not these. But, oh, hold on. I think these over here maybe. Yes, 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 yes. Okay, cool. And then can I get these now? Yes. Okay. Yes. Okay. We're okay. Getting somewhere. Okay, now I feel like we're in, like, a bad spot again, because I don't know where to go. Oh, okay, there's, like, some small random ones over here. Okay, cool. Yes, perfect. Okay, yes. Now we're okay, yes. Yeah. Okay, we already got a size increase. Okay, so we're doing, like, significantly better than we were last time. At least, I think. Seems like it. It really is one of those things where it feels like if you're not, like, rolling up something every, like, 2 seconds, it feels like you're like behind. At least in my head it is. I'm thinking about like popcorn where it's like if it stops popping, if there's this much of a pause between popping, it's done. It's over. Oh, another cousin. A different cousin? Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna use bigger one. Cousin Fujio. Okay, not bad. Already at, okay. Oh no, this is going pretty well. One other text? No, voicemail. Okay, here we go. Now we're getting somewhere. Now we're getting a lot of clouds, and I still have, okay, now I have 2 minutes left. Okay. Let's try and go. It might be like 450. I don't know. It definitely seems like, because I think 390 was only like what, 78%. So, yeah. I don't know. It's gonna be. It's a toughie. There's so many small ones too. Is the thing. DualSense wireless controller batteries. How did that happen? I was charging a while last night. I don't know. The DualSense battery is also like low though, or the dual is like small. How do you say that? Like the battery capacity is small. It's annoying. Okay, so we already beat our previous record of 390, which is great. We still have a pretty good amount of time left. God damn it! Let's keep on going. It's fine. pretty good. I mean, like, I feel like it's like I just want to get to, like, as close as 500 as humanly possible, I guess. But thank you. That feels like 500 definitely feels like that'd be safe. Problem is, I don't think I'm gonna get to 500 right now. I think I'm gonna get pretty close. I'm not gonna do too bad, but. Mm-hmm. 460. Okay. This shouldn't be this stressful, but I feel stressed. Missed one. Okay, there's one over there, 474. Let me get this one, 475. Nah.
Okay.
I mean, I don't think I'm gonna do much better than 474. I mean, I think the best is probably 500, but we'll see. God, I remember that paper cranes one was crazy. I spent so much time on that. I mean, hopefully he just likes this. It looks kind of yummy. Pink for star, blue for mint, but if we're obsessed, we would make an even. Oh, come on! That's 94%! He must want 100%. This true looks good to eat. The yellow ones must taste like bananas. It'd make for a great snack, but no, I already have my sandwiches. I can't have it. Oh, well. I mean, he said he'd make a tastier looking one. I mean, it's 94%, though. 94%'s, like, really good. We'll try it one more time just because it's only a 4-minute mission, but, like, I don't know. Like, 94%, like... So I got... Okay, so I had 474. Or one more time. One more time. So I would like to do a couple, missions. In the stream. It's a Murray. Da-da-da-da. Okay, let's go. Let's go. Back to the grind. I don't think I can get the pigs. Oh, but I got that cloud. I think I can get that. I can get this one. Not get these. Okay. Okay, over here. Over here. Man, I don't really have anything else to talk about. I feel like I'm just, like, I'm out. Like, I'm just, like, back in Katamari mode. I can't think of any interesting topics. I don't even think... Did anything crazy happen while I was gone? Not really. Not to my knowledge, at least. I think everything's most... I mean, everything's always crazy, kind of. I don't think anything's more crazy than usual, I guess. That's maybe the point I'm trying to make, because, like... Usually things are pretty crazy already. Every day it's like some insane new story, but like aliens, that whole thing, it's what a bummer too. And they're like, oh, there's aliens and they're real. It's like, I got other stuff going on. But also it's one of those things where, like, not to be rude, it does feel very selfish that always those stories are always like, yep, and they landed right here in America and they continually flew over America and no other country. And I don't know why, but I don't know. That makes me believe less and less of, like, I don't know, it makes me believe about less about aliens existing in general, just the idea of, like, an alien life form, but more so in terms of, like, the idea of, like, visitors that are coming. That makes me think that that happened way less, because it's like, okay, well, I just feel like maybe they'd visit other, like, why don't they go to Vietnam? Why can't an alien go to Vietnam? Why can't an alien go to Cambodia? Why can't an alien go to fucking Ireland? I don't see why it's always America, where they're like, yep, and we have a bunch of aliens here, and we have Area 51, because they just like America so much. Because why do they like America so much? What is it about America specifically that it's like, Evac Jim followed me? Hey, thank you very much, Evac Jim. Thank you very much for the follow. We are now even closer to Twitch affiliate. I think we're at like 36 out of 50, so we're doing... pretty good. Yo, man, what's up? Not much. What's up with you? Thank you very much for following. Oh, no, I was at 474 last time. I don't know. If I was an alien, I feel like I would go to other countries and make appearances just to spite America. Even if I don't have a concept of, like, what America is as an alien in terms of, like... the injustices and everything, I would, like, if I saw the stories, that's like, yeah, no, like, America's known for, like, you know, like, if you're in, like, alien, I don't know, the cafe or whatever, And they're like, yeah, America said they saw us again. And it's like, okay, they always say they see us, but like, we're not even there half the time. Like, some, yes, sure, sometimes it's us, but like, we're going other places, and like, they always try to, you know, take credit for our stuff. I don't know. I'd make it a point to go other places. I'd be going to China. I would be going the fuck out of China. I don't think I'd go to Australia if I was an alien, though. There are some places I wouldn't want to go. If I was an alien, I definitely feel like I'd feel less safe in like places like Australia. But maybe you'd blend in easier in Australia just because they always have like freaky shit. Like kangaroo, if you really think about it and you really look about like a kangaroo, those are disgusting. Those are disgusting giant rat monsters that like they've cultivated. Like, not that I want any species of animal to go extinct, because like morally and scientifically, blah 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 blah, all that, you know, all that stuff. Kangaroos are just nasty as hell. I mean, you look at them and like they look like creatures, like crimes against humanity. I don't know. I don't know. Like, I couldn't support one. You know what I mean? Like, I could not support a kangaroo. Okay, so we got 489, so I did do better. I almost got 100%. I worry that he'll only be happy if I get 100%, which isn't undoable. Like, obviously we're getting very close, we're doing better every time. But I'm kind of hoping that he'll just be cool with this. Oh no! He's, okay, so comfy and pleasant, this Katamari. It's not about it's about the fluffiness. Okay, cool. Perfect. 97%. Filter the field trip, okay. Blah blah blah, we're gonna keep it. Cool, yeah. We did it. Planet. That rules. Because there's definitely part of me that's like, well, maybe I will just do it one more time to get 100%, but I didn't have to. Very glad. Okay, so I feel like these two old ladies are gonna be huge bitches. Not to be rude, but just like, I don't know. Oh, I'm at 40%. Does that mean I'm only at 40% of the stages done? I wonder if that's including the stuff with like the king. I'm Hansel and I'm Gretel. Together we're Hansel and Gretel. We love Katamari Damacy, but we love sweets too. We came all this way because we heard the king can grant wishes. We want to stuff ourselves. Whoops. How about it? I don't know what voice I'm doing for them, to be completely honest. I could not tell you. Oh, alone today. It's not that easy rolling Katamari, is it? Well, actually, it's not easy for us either. It's not easy to just sit and watch. No. Huh? What? Sweets? You want to eat sweets? Ooh, we want to eat them too. Really and honestly, a good idea. Let's go eat. Great. That one he was on board with. Na 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 na. Oh. Okay. We finally found it. We found the gingerbread house. It smells like buttercream. So yummy. No, no, we must control ourselves. Already have this much time to roll up the gingerbread house. Then, once the sweets Katamari is big enough, roll up these two fans. We're sure you can do it, the prince. Alrighty, it's all yours now. Okay. So, I have to roll up sweets. But then I have to go back and roll them up within... Oh my god. Within the 3 minutes. Okay. We can do this. By the way, I was lurking around and came across your mail. Can help you out with Twitch custom graphics even more. That's a very nice offer. I am not currently interested, though, sorry to say. I'm pretty cool with everything I got going on right here. Oop, donuts. Donuts make me God, oh, you know what? Yeah, sure, man. No worries. Have a good one. Thank you, you too. I found out that, like, well, I mean, I already knew that, like, I guess I had to learn it, but, like, that whole saying of, like, time to make the donuts is from, like, literally, like, a Dunkin' Donuts, like, series of commercials with, like, a guy, and then, I forget if he died, if he retired when he stopped, but basically, Dunkin' Donuts used to make all their donuts in-house, and then, like, I want to say, like, within, like, 6 months of that dude dying, or, like, retiring, or whichever one happened, like, basically when the ad campaign stopped, they, like, very quickly started, having other people make the donuts for them. Like, literally, he was, like, I guess he was the reason why they kept making the donuts at Dunkin' Donuts. It's, like, crazy. It's, like, there's no way it's a coincidence that they just so happen to stop, like, immediately. Like, oh, crazy. I think he's dead now. I think they just stopped the campaign, but I'm pretty sure he's dead. Okay. Once it's big enough, take the sweets Katamari and roll up. And yeah, don't you worry about that. Wow, this is nuts. So much stuff. I mean, I feel like I can, like, wait until I have, like, 20 seconds left. Oh, speaking of the devil, I'm almost there. I have all this fun to get. Oh, I don't have the present either. Ooh, okay, doing better. Okay. Hello. Don't, he's gonna remind me to roll up the pants, too, otherwise it's a count. I really want to try and get this stuff right here, because the fans, like, aren't far. Here, come here. Come here. Come here. 30 seconds left. Okay. Whoop! Real quick. Really make sure I'm getting my money's worth here. 16. Where's the fans right there? Oh, man, I definitely wasted time. But I mean, I feel like I got almost everything. Alrighty, want to go home? Yeah. Let's see how that was. Because I mean, like, you know what? Maybe I was supposed to get to 3 meters. Because I got real close. I got 2.91 meters. That might have been a... Like, I had... I don't know. I mean, I definitely had, like, 10 seconds. Like, they're even closer than I remembered. The gingerbread house, you found it. It was just sitting there. Who knew? We're a little choked up. So here we are. This is the sweets catamaran. The catamaran that we could only dream of. It's full of sugary goodness. Yes, fed. Unbelievable. No doubt, Hanson are very, very content. I guess they're... He's happy. 97%. Yeah, I did a good job. Wow, we got a long nose as a present. Fabulous. It's so intense, but it's far too small for us. The prince, you can have it. It's from a fan, so make sure you appreciate it. This Katamari is snackious. It's full of treats. You were great, your highness. Munch the gingerbread house. That was a thrill. We're covered in cream and crumbs after getting rolled up in the sweets Katamari. Oh, we're full now. You can have the rest, your highness. Oh, really? You're giving it to us? Seriously? Fabulous. Thank you. We're so pleased. What should we do with it? Oh, we can pop it up into the cosmos. Yes, that's what we'll do. Nailed it in one. Look at me. It's gonna be a planet. That looks yummy. Biscuit planet. Cool. Man, if I can get like a third, you know what, disembodied nerd? If I can get like a third mission done real quick, maybe I could do like one round of DBD. Maybe. That depends on how long this is. Hey, I'm a bird. That's right, I'm a bird. I love Katamari Damacy. I played until my feathers fell out while I played. I think, gosh, if I were that big, what? When wrong, you can be big inside. Oh, that's true, but being big inside, it's all about heart. Please, good king, won't you let me roll? I don't understand what he wants, really, but I was also kind of reading a little too fast. It makes us think, what are we going to do? What will we do when we grow up? Oh, the prince, panda, giraffe, which is more us? What? A bird? A little bird wants to be bigger? Well, why doesn't he just go do it? Your highness is tweedily wonderful. Wonderful. Yes, yes, let's do what we like. Let's make a bigger Katamari, foot loose and fancy free. Whew, shall we go then? Okay. Katamari. There's no point in thinking about the future, so let's start rolling. Wow, a 1 meter Katamari right off the bat. That's a heaping spoonful extra. Oh, isn't that nice, the prince? You're so lucky. Anyway, today's lucky winner gets this much time to make this big a Katamari. How fortuitous. Lucky the prince, it's all yours now. Okay, so we're not doing Dead by Daylight. This is the rest of the stream. And hopefully I can get... I mean, is he just going to be happy if I get to 500 meters? And, like, hopefully there's no extra credit or anything. I wonder if it's like a speed thing though. I forget. Does he get mad about speed in this one? Do 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 do. My God. Well, it's definitely an interesting start so far. Oh my God. Oh my God. Okay. Well. 500 meters, huh? Gonna be a little big. Gonna be a little big for the britches. Okay. But now I really have to think about things to talk about, because there's not gonna be a lot to talk about for this. Not that there's not gonna be stuff happening, but, like, you know, this is 500 meters. Like, we're gonna be here a while. There's only so much I can say about so many different household objects. Shit, I don't know. Maybe I'll just play the... Maybe we'll just have, like, a little calm down minute. Except it's, you know, 16 minutes. That's just an excuse for me to think about things. Oh, low power mode turned off. That's nice. God, I'm trying to think of like celebrity news because all I know is pop culture bullshit. And one of my first thoughts was, did Nick Cannon have another kid? And the answer is no, at least to my knowledge. But that does take that whole topic away from me, I guess. Which, like, I mean, we already knew this, but he's a selfish man. Come here. I can get to three meters and make it to the next area. Perfect. I might still want to clean up a little bit in the first area. I don't know. I mean, like, not to, like, sound like me, but, like, I feel like a lot of what I read about now is just, like, either, like, local drama and, like, the area I live in. Like, I found out there's, like, two different places in the mall that, like, haven't been paying their rent for months, and so the mall's trying to evict them, but they're like, no, no, it's fine. Which I do think is very funny. And then also, a lot of high-speed rail. Like, every day I'll just be like, what's going on with trains? Not even high-speed rail, not even just high-speed, just, like, trains in general. Like, what are any new advancements on, like, how's Amtrak doing? Are they going to bring back more of the cross-country routes? Are we going to expand the cross-country routes? How is the Azalea class going? Are we going to get those, like, faster trains this year? I think we're supposed to get, like, faster Azalea trains. You know, like, what's going on there? Which, like, high-speed rail is great, because that's, like, what, like, 200... Is that 200 miles an hour or 200 kilometers? I think it's miles. I'm pretty sure it's miles. And they're like, yeah, they can only do, like, 100. But, like, I don't know, 100 miles an hour. That's, like... I'm still happy with that. Like, obviously, in the future, definitely, high-speed rail, way to go. But, like, even in terms of now, like, I'd be cool. More trains that go that fast. Which is just, like, a tracks issue in regards to, like, the tracks can't, like, take the capacity or, like, they can't handle those speeds. So we, like, upgrade them, which would be, like, a whole thing. Even though I think they're, like, working on, like, ways to get around that. I think it's, like, turns or something where they're, like, I forget. There's, like, some kind of technology, like, that they're trying to do to, like, kind of retrofit the older tracks that, like, oh, you can go, like, high speed rail, but, like, you can get, like, a little bit faster than, like, conventional would, like, normally let you. That's, like, promising. What are you guys doing over here? Sorry for interrupting it, but, like, what is happening? Can I unlock a new area, like, already? I think they're adding the Little Mermaid, the live action one, to Disney Plus like today or tomorrow or something. That movie flopped at the box office. It's like a weird thing where, like, one, I'm black, but two, I also hate the live action Disney remakes. So it's very emotionally confusing as to how to feel about it. Because on one hand, it's like, hey, why don't you guys watch it? On the other hand, it's like, hey. All these movies are just, like, annoying cash grabs and stupid and look worse. But, you know. I guess that was my whole point, to be fair. That was the whole point. Yeah, I don't know. I think they're all annoying. And not enough animated remakes of things, because we always treat animation like, I mean, it is weird, because I do agree with those Twitter posts. It's basically, like, yes, animation is, like, its own, like, medium and not just, like, a genre, but then it's also, like, hard when, like, the majority of the people that are, like, animation is not a genre are, like, posting about, like, kid stuff. Not that kid stuff is, like, bad inherently, but, like, you know, it doesn't, you know, it doesn't help. And also, I know that, like, so much adult animation is, like, good, because then it's like South Park and you're like, okay, well, this isn't gonna, like, change any minds here. God, I remember there was that, like, I think it was like a Fox show that they lit, and like all the people were just like spears or something. It was really ugly. It was crazy. If I can find it, maybe after, if I remember after. It's funny. Is it just he's just gonna keep talking until he loads it? You can more places if you're rolling from here. Okie dokie, do your best. I'm trying to remember. If I remember to look it up after this mission, I will for sure. But like, it was crazy. Like, they're just like circles. Like, they're just like all circle people. They're the exact same template, but then they just do faces. And there's other shows that feel like they're like money laundering or something. Or like something like, oh, what was it like? Drunk Wine Mom got like its own show, which I guess was a Twitter account that was semi-popular like in the early years, which I did not know anything about. But somehow she got a Netflix show, which is a whole other thing with like Netflix and like all these strikes, and they're like, no, we don't have any money. But then God, did Netflix just greenlight anything for like so long? It was anything. They're like, yeah, we had an idea for a show. They're like, yeah, go for it. But then also it's like they'll greenlight anything. They will not give anything a season two. That's the other problem. It's like there's so much stuff on Netflix that I've thought about watching only to find out, oh, it got canceled prematurely. So like it just sounds like a cliffhanger, which isn't inherently bad, but it's like, God, it's like I would like to just like watch a whole show that actually feels like finished by the end of it, or like that I don't think is going to get canceled, or like, you know, it isn't like it's all for nothing. You still like enjoy the parts you did like, but it is still like frustrating when it's like, okay, and that just sounds like a cliffhanger and that you had more stuff that they wanted to do, but not happening. Not happening. Especially when there's other shows that they also like let go on for like way too long. To the point where everyone's like, alright, I think we've had enough of this. They're like, no, we can keep going. House of Cards went on too long, even before Kevin Spacey died, I feel like. Died. Well, his character died. And then he was just dead to us as a society. Unless you're like in Europe or whatever, I think he's still acting because they're a bunch of fucking pervert freaks. Or fucking people like Roman Polanski can just like make movies and everyone's like, yeah, no, it's fine. But the most depressing thing you can ever look up is like all the different fucking directors and celebrities that signed that thing that's like, no, Roman Polanski should be brought back to America. Which I don't know how many of them like changed their minds, but like even then, it's like I feel like the details of that case were like very open and shut even at the time. Like I feel like we haven't learned that much new information that makes him look worse. Like I feel like he looked bad already, very bad. But still, these people were like, no, bring him back. It's fine. It's so good. Like he made Rosemary's Baby. It's like, okay, well he's also a sex pervert and he should, you know. I mean, you know, we want to talk about, you know, justice. He should probably be, like, executed by, like, a firing squad or something. Because, like, you know, he's a pedophile. That's not even, like, alleged. That's just what he is. That's why he's in Europe. Because he fucking fled America to escape, what's the word? Jurisdiction. Because he knew he was guilty. He's a pedophile. He just did that. But yeah, I think it was Wes Anderson, one of them. It was like depressing. Where it's like you look at them, it's like all these people that you like, you have like either neutral or positive feelings towards, and they're like, yeah, no, Roman's great. Why do you think Roman's great? Wow, like come on, oh my god, that was like, I think is it the guy that did Jeepers Creepers? I think it was Jeepers Creepers, someone who like was like arrested for like, being a pedophile, and they're like, yeah, it's fine. He can keep making the Jeepers Creepers. You know, they make millions of dollars. Who cares? Let him keep making his fucking stupid-ass Jeepers Creepers movies. Like, what is wrong with you people? Truly. Like, I don't know, man. Hollywood is all just, like, insane financial fraud. But they just lie about everything. All those like, all that stuff is, like, so insanely, like, not true. And they cook the books. They cook the fuck out of those books. Which is why I'm very much for the writers and the actors and their strikes. Like, unions are very powerful and they are important. Yeah, it's like I going to like school and everything where you learn like, yeah, no, they do just lie. Like, the studios lie about pretty much every aspect of every part of like the financial process of like every movie and TV show they've ever made ever. And lawsuits are like common between actors and studios and directors and studios because for whatever reason they just don't want to pay, but then if they get caught they'll be like, all right, fine, and then it's like not a big deal. Like that was like I think the thing with like Scarlett Johansson and Disney where I think it was like, oh my god, they're underpaying ScarJo, but then it was like weird because then like I remember like it was like, yeah, no, this just happens. Like I think Peter Jackson had to like sue to get money back for like Lord of the Rings because like I think they tried to pretend that Lord of the Rings actually didn't make them money and that they actually lost money on the Lord of the Rings movies. Because they just do that. They just like to lie and be like, no, we didn't make any money, because then it's like taxes and other like Like, it's all just, like, an insane amount of lying. But then also it's, like, they're run by, like, very, like, I don't know. It feels like they're good at, like, hiding money, but then terrible about, like, making money a lot of the time. Like, I don't know what is going on with, like, DC and, like, them being like, we're not doing the Batwoman movie. I do think it was smart. Like, I will say it sucks. Like, I'm not, like, supporting it. Like, it does suck when stuff's, like, approved or, like, in the planning process and then it gets kind of, like, pulled. These people, like, kind of get the rug pulled out from under them in regards to, like, you know, the movies that they're being told that they're allowed to make and stuff like that. Like, but also it's one of those things where it's like, okay, yeah, I get why you did that. We're like, I think they wanted to do like a $100 million Wonder Twins movie, but I think they also wanted it to be HBO Max exclusive. Which like, hey, I get it. You know what? I get that one. I get why you didn't want to do a whole expensive ass Wonder Twins movie and make it HBO Max exclusive. But it is weird when it's like, yep, Batwoman, you know, got canceled or whatever. Not that I would have, I mean, like all the DC movies are like not great. But it's one of those things where it's like, okay, but, like, then you approved The Flash, and you didn't even actually do the thing that you said you were gonna, or, I don't know if they actually said that they were gonna do it, but it was, like, implied that they were gonna do it, where, like, The Flash was gonna, like, reset the DC, like, universe, so that way it's like, okay, we're doing all this stuff now, but then they, like, changed it. I mean, they said that, I think he already gave the details about the other ending, where it, like, wasn't gonna be George Clooney produced. The Flash was just gonna, like, see Batman and be like, you look different, and then that was the implication of, like, yes, there's something afoot, which is weird that they're like, we gotta stick with Ezra Miller, truly. And then The Flash did terrible at the box office, and now Blue Beetle is doing not great at the box office. It will probably also be a bomb, I think. I could be wrong, but I think it's on track to be a bomb. I think just all those deep, like, I don't know, it feels weird. It's like, okay, these are the ones you keep, and these, you know, I just wouldn't do any of them at that point. It does suck that Westworld got canceled, but I also think that, like, it was insane that season 4 could have just been the ending, like, in my opinion. Everything past season 1 was, like, not great. I think I was more interested in season 4 compared to, like, 2 and 3, for sure, where I was like, okay, wait, hold on, maybe we're, like, getting somewhere. Like, this is, like, interesting, at least, like, for the most part. Like, I'm, like, intrigued as, like, what's going on. But, like, yeah, they really never did anything better than season 1. I mean, it's almost like Stranger Things, where it's like, yep, great season 1, and then everything after that's kind of been like, okay, except I guess Stranger Things season 4 also liked, so I was like, okay, well, we're getting somewhere with this. But yeah, I mean, at least everyone's getting paid for season 5. And then I think the writers said that they were going to, like, release some kind of thing to basically be like, okay, this is what the ending of Westworld is going to be, based on, like, our planning. Yeah, that whole season with, like, Aaron Paul just sucked, though. Not to be mean, but, like, God, that was... Or no, yes. Yeah, it was the season with Aaron Paul, right? Or is season Paul and Paul in season 4, too? Season 3 is the one where I remember was like, fuck, this is so fucking boring. If I'm remembering correctly. Season 2 was like, I'm interested, but then my interest was just like waning and waning and waning. God, am I gonna get to 500 meters? I would hate to find out that I spent all this time doing this and only to not get to 500, but it's entirely possible. I only have 3 minutes left. I mean, I know it's exponential. I say that all the time. It's exponential, but like still, this is like, I don't know. But yeah, I don't know. I don't know what's up with them. Ooh, present. It's crazy. I think the writers are, like, getting somewhere with it all. And then I think, like, HBO Max just released a thing where they, like, expect to lose, like, $300 to $500 million based on the fact that they haven't been able to, like, film anything. Which, like, whose fault is that? I don't know how that works, too, where it's like, okay, we're willing to lose, you know, $500 million... or not willing to, you know, spend the money to, like, I guess because it sets a precedent for, like, the rest of, like, the actors and the writers and everything, I guess maybe is the thing. But forget the panda thing. We don't want to be a panda. We are us. The king is the king. We just realized that we are nothing without Katamari Damacy. The king of cosmos exists to make sure that everyone has a nice, happy time. It supports to think ahead, but not as important as being in the moment. Okay, let's make this Katamari even bigger. Let's do it. Got it. Okay, I'm at 314, so, you know, 500 meters is within our grasp. six pick. I have not been doing my dash at all. I don't think I did the dash at all. Oh god, I'm not gonna get to 500 meters. I'm gonna have to do this whole thing again. That's frustrating. Oh, c'est la vie. Maybe I'll do that one off screen. Cousin Ichigo! Cousin Ichigo, love you. I mean, I'll get close, but... I think I spent too much time on those other areas, because I always think, like, oh, I gotta, like... Which I think, depending on, like, how big you're going, I think can be helpful. I think for something like this, we're getting, like, insanely big, I think it's, like, you do just have to go from area to area and not spend too much time getting too much bigger in those other ones. Oh my god, I'm stuck. He's gonna call me a failure. He's gonna be right, because I failed! Unless, hold on, hold on. Nope. Okay. Well, oh god, so close. Nope. Well, that's a bummer. Birds can't roll. We slipped up and thought about the future, but that stuff, whatever happens, will happen on its own. What we're trying to say is Katamari is down to see this game mode getting bigger this time around in Katamari, so you can roll around lots of places. There's more fun, more things than two-player cooperative rolling, but after all, it's Katamari Dallas because you roll and roll. The prince, don't forget that part. Don't take complacent just because you made it a little bigger. Today. Ooh, that's kind of a waste. This camera is kind of a waste. It got biggish, but it's kind of a waste. We should try to recycle it. Oh, we can turn it into Stardust. Let's make the universe so much prettier. Thank you very much to everyone who came to today's stream. Sorry we ended on a failure. You know, we did. We ended on a failure, but, I don't know how you check how much is left. I truly don't know. I mean, I know we have these three people right here, but I don't know how you know. I mean, it feels like we're close to the end. Can I look up We Love Katamari missions? List of stages, maybe. I don't know how this helps me. Okay, clouds. Oh, but they, like, categorize it in, like, a way that, like, it's hard to... Yeah, I don't know how to, like, categorize... Because they, like, categorize it, like, based on, like, the theme of it. I don't know how to, like, look up just, like, this is what they have. I don't know. Yeah. Oh, this seems to have all the levels, maybe. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10, 11, 12, I'm not counting all that. I forgot there's the roses in this one, but I think that one's when you just, like, come back to, you roll a bunch, then come back to a bunch. But yeah, that's it for today. Thank you very much. Hopefully next time, I might be able to stream tomorrow, actually. I think tomorrow I can stream again. So, hopefully look forward to that. Either more kind of Mario or Dead by Daylight. I have to change the game on, like, the thing, because I think I said Dead by Daylight on, like, the Twitch metadata, so I have to change that. But, thank you very much to Somebody Nerd for showing up. Thank you very much to Evac Jim, who, followed during the stream and is also the most recent follower. Thank you. Oh, did that, let me make sure that updated in the, yes, it did. In the thing, yes. Oh, bye, Disembodied Nerd. But yeah, thank you all very much. Thank you to all those who watch the VODs. And I'll see you next time. Bye. As I'm going to the stream ending thing. Bye.